Yeah. You know, I've been around for a while now. Not sure if I have much left to prove. Yeah, I do. I look at me now, I'm thinking, damn, how proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France. I look around, I see the fans, how they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands. They're hollering, shame, yelling it out to me. And that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all, man, but in actuality, I haven't yet.
Where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Got no time for no haters in this bitch. Or toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital waiting room will get. What I mean is maybe I have more patience than I'm able to admit. Yeah, but I'm still mentally stable. There's a three-legged table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade the shit for the trailer with a hitch that it would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt, now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. And I'm just berating you with it. It's shady till I'm 82. I spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
So where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Go from here, my boy. Hey, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
If we learn anything from watching 8 Mile, is that when it comes to battle rap, don't come for Eminem. He will be the first to tell you that he treats the rap game the same way the world's best athletes treat their respective sport, with a 24/7 tenacity that only the elite are able to channel. He spent his entire life studying and training to be the best, but even with a life of preparation, will it be enough for his next battle? It's one thing to conquer your competition. It's another to conquer your demons. With us now to share his thoughts is Dana White, who knows a thing or two about marquee battles. Dana, thanks for being with us. How prepared can one be when going up against an opponent of this magnitude?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Listen, I'm a huge Eminem fan, but this is a tough one. This opponent is not someone you can prepare for. It's a tricky demon to conquer, even for someone as badass as Eminem. My prediction is disappointment for fans all over the world.
That's interesting. We are now joined by the man himself, Eminem. Em, appreciate it. What's your response to what Dana just said?
I want to say, first of all, thank you for having me on. I think that people like you give people like me the fuel that they need to succeed in the first place. So I think that the best part about your opinion is that it doesn't matter. And if every fighter that you had listened to your opinion when you doubted them, you wouldn't have a f***ing league. So you're an a**hole and I'm out.
Well, he definitely sounds ready. In any case, it should be a battle for the ages. Thank you, Dana. And best of luck to you, Eminem.
I'm on the loose, born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. With my record flop, I still go through the roof. This atmosphere is for a chosen few who was on their grind making money moves. And you ain't gonna get there if you water down. You gotta take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode since a 5-year-old, it was I alone. Since my track was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back how bad it was then, if it hadn't have been for the pad and the pen addict, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within. Having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMD must have had teaching degrees. Learned to defeat enemies with the ink. Thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E. And graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. The east side slums, gotta remind them. I'll take a foe out like feet by thumb. You see my finger, you see my thumb. You see my fist for my peace pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung, for the beef I've come. But you better bring it if you wanna reclap from. Cause for you to be lyrically inclined, it'd be a steep climb up. That'll be an uphill battle, but I'm up like your feet in a recliner.
And I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher, cause
where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. To go from here, oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.